There's no chemical reaction taking place here. So why is it that the liquid in this flask appears to light up when I place it in front of this filter? Well, I have a backlight, in this case an OHP, and I'm blocking all of the light that isn't passing through this filter with a piece of cardboard here. This is a polarizing filter I've borrowed from the physics department. There's a second polarizing filter mounted to the front of the lens. So in theory, there shouldn't be any light coming from the OHP getting through to the back of the camera. Your physics departments are probably going to have some of these filters lying around. They're used for showing things like stress patterns in plastic. You could either mount another large filter directly in front of the light source, or you could pass out smaller filters for your viewers to hold. This is a solution of sucrose. It's a chiral molecule, and it's dextrorotatory, i.e. it rotates plain polarized light to the right, so it's now able to pass through the second filter. Other sugars, like glucose and fructose, are chiral too. Glucose rotates light to the right, hence also been known as dextrose. Fructose, which is sold in supermarkets as fruit sugar, rotates light strongly to the left, and is also lesser known as levulose. But have I just added a glucose solution or a fructose solution? Both look the same. However, if you turn one of the filters back and forth, you can see our solutions are rotating in opposite directions. The one on your left is fructose. Now here's a cool extension. This solution here started off exactly the same as the sucrose solution on your right. I added a few drops of lemon juice and then boiled gently for about 5 minutes. Sucrose is a disaccharide of glucose and fructose. What I've done is to begin hydrolyzing it. We now have a mixture of sucrose rotating right, glucose rotating right, and fructose which rotates strongly left. Watch as I rotate. The solution in the center now rotates somewhere between the other two. Left hydrolyzing long enough, the solution will begin to rotate left, hence being known as invert sugar syrup. Invert sugar syrup is highly prized by the food industry because compared to sucrose, it's sweeter. It has a lower water activity, which means it has a longer shelf life, and also it's less prone to crystallization. The reaction in the industry is actually followed by polarimetry. I've had these flasks for a few weeks, so they'll keep long enough for a whole year group to see. You can however see that the sucrose has begun to crystallize, whilst the fructose and the partially hydrolyzed sucrose have not. One of the best reasons to show this demonstration is that it draws out the point that chirality is a property of the whole molecule, not just a sum of the individual carbon atoms within it. Because glucose rotates to the right and fructose more heavily to the left, you would expect sucrose, which is made up of the two subunits, to rotate to the left. As we have seen, it does not.